control. Brought back, run by Johansson. Johansson spirits his way through and a backhand. It's good!
I think it's really important that the guys, I mean, we keep talking about the lineup changes and a lot of guys up from Wilkes-Barre, and the guys from Wilkes-Barre aren't the guys who are making mistakes lately. It's the guys that have been here all year. So I think it's a lot of onus on the guys that have been here to kind of lead the way and lead by example. And in the last couple of games, it's been the guys that have been here for a while making the mistakes, not the guys that have come up. The guys that have come up have done a really good job.
Lost in the shuffle of players to the injured reserve list and back and forth from Wilkes-Barre is that the veteran-laden blue line has struggled as of late. While offense has mustered less than 2 goals per game in their last 5, the defense has given up nearly 4.5 per tilt.
We each have a role in this team, and it shouldn't change no matter what, you know. And we know what to expect from one another, and you know, that's how we should play. We shouldn't be, you know, trying to be somebody else. Just try to be, you know, ourselves and play our game. And that's why, you know, each of us got here, and we shouldn't change because, you know, there is a few guys missing.
With several key figures out indefinitely, the Penguins will need to find a way to recapture their winning ways.
We haven't been played disciplined hockey lately. We got a lot of penalties, and you know, not doing the stuff that you know we have to do. You know, to get the pucks deep, you know, get on the forecheck, and you know, we spend a lot of time in our zone, and you know, that's when trouble starts. And we have to make sure we manage the puck better, play in the offensive zone. You know, spend as much time we can, you know, grind them down, and you know, the teams are doing that to us right now, and we are taking penalties, you know, and that's you know, part of the reason why you know, we allowed so many goals last 2 games, I think.
And keep in mind, before losing 4 of their last 5, the Pens rattled off 5 straight, largely due to the stingy defense.
I think we take pride in playing really well defensively, and you know, as a team, you know, you look at Fleury's stats since he came back at them. It was really rare we got more than 2 goals against, and that's something we take pride in, is playing well defensively. And usually the offense gonna come with itself. But we're really comfortable winning games 2-1, 3-1, and we're gonna have to come back to that.
I don't think we've deviated or gone on our own page as much as maybe we've tried to assume too much of what we see from Sidney Crosby. We need to make sure we're focused on playing their role and their part in how we play, and do that to the best of their ability. And that's maybe where our focus is. It's good intentions, and maybe they're trying to step up their game a little more, but it's really more making sure they bring their foundation, what they bring to the team, and bring it to the best of their ability. And that's where we really need to go to get back the mojo.
And the mojo has been missing the last...
So, he's not a young rookie. He's getting a chance to show what he can do, and so far, he's been very impressive.
Scoring that first goal against LA, you know, made me settle down a little bit, but, you know, it's basically my third stint here in the NHL, and I'm hoping this one will help me stick. But getting more and more confident every time, and you start to feel like, you know I can play at this level, and just continue to do what I do. Hopefully get some chances, shoot the puck and score some goals, and help this team win some games.
All right, Stanley, thank you very much, and welcome to the Mile High City, where the Penguins hope to get back on the winning track tonight against the Colorado Avalanche. And, Coach, I wanted to ask you about the kids. I keep referring to them as the kids, but they've been here for a while now, and you'll have 5 members of the Wilkes-Barre Scranton Penguins in the starting lineup, or in the lineup tonight. This will be their 4th game within the last 10 days. They are producing, they are helping, but do you feel that they've kind of reached a comfort level, kind of getting through the initial, okay, I'm in the NHL and I'm playing with some guys that I haven't played with, but maybe relaxed a little bit?
Yeah, I don't know if comfortable is the word we want them to get, but relaxed. And, you know, I know there's some nerves and getting used to the NHL and maybe getting used to sleeping at night with those nerves. Hopefully they're starting to settle in a little bit because they are factors for us in every game. We need them to play well. They know how to play. They've been doing that in Wilkes-Barre, winning hockey games there. They're coming up here. They just need to play the same way and add with what they bring, and they have been doing that.
Throughout most of the season, you've had to move some pieces around on the power play. Now, a lot of that recently has been due to injury, but this morning you had guys out there like Tyler Kennedy, Jordan Staal, and Brett Sterling. Talk about that mix and what it is about those particular individuals that appeals to you.
Well, you've talked about those guys. They each bring something to that power play that's unique, and they've been bringing it, doing pretty well with it. Tyler Kennedy,
attacks off the half wall and can add that shot. He scored a few goals on that. Jordan Staal's a big body recovering pucks, but in big in front of the net, and he's been there. You saw that last game. Brett Sterling in that slot area for a high tip, but also for that shot, and he's been able to get that shot off and score for us. But he's also a factor in help kind of moving pucks around, distributing it, and then compliments Chris Letang and Alex Galagoski back in the point, guys who can deliver the puck to the net.
Your opponent tonight has been struggling as of late. They were hoping to get some help from someone like Peter Forsberg, but two games in, and now he's done. We found out earlier today we will not see Matt Duchene. He's out indefinitely. How do you hope to take advantage of the struggles that they've had recently?
Well, we haven't been at the top of our game the last few games as well, so really focus on our game, really our puck management, give us a chance to have success. And really, we want to dictate this game, make sure we play in the offensive zone. We don't want to give these guys any life, and if we can put them back on their heels, we'd like to do that.
All right, Coach, best of luck.
Thank you.
Stan, Dan, and Dan have spoken. The Pens and Avs are coming your way at 9 o'clock. We'll see you then.
All right, Dan, thank you very much. Happy anniversary, Coach. You think you are a long way from Denver?
Is our Pepsi Max bench interview, and you spent 4 years here at the Colorado College playing hockey, but tonight you're playing NHL hockey for the first time since playing college hockey here. So what kind of emotions are you feeling?
Oh, it's awesome. I'm excited for tonight's game. I mean, they got a good team over there, but it's fun to be back in Colorado and playing hockey here.
In three games so far with the Penguins this season, you have 3 points. You're on the first line tonight. You're on the first power play unit tonight. Are you starting to feel a little bit more comfortable and starting to feel some confidence?
Yeah, I'm getting my confidence here, but comfortable, I don't know about that. I mean, obviously, there's a lot of guys here, and I'm just trying to keep my spot here and continue to play the way I have been and hopefully put a few more pucks in the back of the net.
All right, Brett, thank you very much.
Thanks a lot.
Gentlemen, it's all yours.
All right, thank you very much, Dan. Dan Biles will make some changes again tonight in the Toyota.